Hey, this is John Fernay, the co-host of the Maryland Crabs, and I am here today with a Maryland Crabcake for your listening pleasure. What's a crabcake? It's not quite a full episode, it's just a little snippet. Stay tuned and check it out. And make sure you check us out on themarylandcrabs.com. You can follow us on Twitter at MDCrabsPodcast or find us on Facebook at the Maryland Crabs Podcast. And don't forget, subscribe, rate us, iTunes, go there now. Hey, and here's an idea for you for your Wednesday evening fun. Come on over to the Lighthouse Bistro on West Street for their happy hour. Tim Hamilton, my co-host on the Maryland Crabs, and myself will be guest bartending for their happy hour. So come on over at about 5 p.m., say hello, have a drink, buy us a drink, but stop by the Lighthouse Bistro right on West Street. If you've not been there, it's a great place. It's got a great story. It's doing great work for everybody in our community. Parking right around the corner at the Knighton Garage, just behind Metropolitan and Lemongrass. And we will see you on Wednesday, the 25th at 5 p.m. at the Lighthouse. Now that I'm done talking about the Lighthouse Shelter Bistro, let's get on with the crab cake. Hey, this is John Fernay, and on the phone with me today, I got Daryl Steurmer, who is the, I don't want to say a former lead guitarist of Genesis, but because Genesis is not really playing as a group anymore, but he was the lead guitarist of Genesis and currently tours with his own duo as well as Phil Collins. And he will be coming to the Ram's Head on October 25th for one show, and tickets are still available. How are you today, Daryl?
I'm doing great, John. Nice to talk to you.
We were talking a little bit before we started, but you're out in Milwaukee.
I'm in Milwaukee.
And I was reading a little bit about you, and that's where you got your start.
It is. I'm here. And I have an older brother. He's 2.5 years older than me, and he's a bass player. But when we were younger, he started playing guitar before I ever did. And, because you admire your brother is always your hero and everything. So I got interested in guitar because of him. And then as I got better playing guitar, I kind of passed him up as a guitarist, and he went to bass, and he's a bass player to this day. But and then we started bands when we were in our early teens, 13, 14 years old. And then we had a band called Sweet Bottom in Milwaukee that got to be a very popular group around town. And we ended up playing in a nightclub for 3 years, 5 nights a week, playing any kind of music we liked.
That's not a bad gig for a teenager or, a young musician.
Yeah. I mean, I was playing in the nightclubs when I was 16, and he was of age, but I was not. And
that probably worked out pretty well for you, didn't it?
It really did. Well, what happened is that we were kind of known as the band. If another band comes into town that's playing one of the theaters or the arenas, they'd say, where could we go? And they say, why don't you go down and see this band called Sweet Bottom? So one night, Frank Zappa's band came into town, and they came down, and they all sat in with us at different times. And the keyboard player, which was a guy named George Duke, he really liked my playing, and he ended up recommending me to play with Jean-Luc Ponty, the French jazz violinist.
Right. Wow.
So I ended up going out to L.A., and at this time I was 21. And at this time, I went out to L.A., and I ended up auditioning for Jean-Luc, and I ended up playing with him for 3 years. That was 1975, 76, and 1977. So I ended up touring with him for 3 years. And
holy
after
mackerel.
That, that's, yeah. And then after that, that's when I got an audition to try out for Genesis, and then the rest is history.
When you get an invitation to try out for Genesis and you said this is 1978. I mean, is this
right?
I mean, how big was your head?
Well, I'll tell you what happened was somebody else auditioned for Genesis, and they didn't get it because he was a bass player, but they needed a guitarist that could play some bass, not a bass player that could play some guitar, because it was a pretty, you had to replace Steve Hackett, which was, kind of a tall order anyway. And that guy didn't get it, but he recommended me, which was really nice. And that's how I got the call to come and do an audition. And I was just ended up auditioning with Mike Rutherford in New York. I just flew to New York. They flew me to New York and auditioned me, and I got it. And I've been with them ever since.
Fantastic. Fantastic. Well, and you're going out on tour next month with Phil Collins in the UK, right?
Yes. Yeah. So, that's exactly right. Yeah.
So this is...
we actually just a few months ago we were touring Europe. We did we played in London. We played the Albert Hall there, and we ended up playing a week in Cologne, Germany. A week in Paris. We played in Dublin at a stadium, and then we came back to London again and played Hyde Park, which was 65,000 people.
Wow!
And it's always amazing. You know, you think, well, you know, Phil Collins has been off tour for quite a long time. Will the people show up? Well, they did. It was every show was sold out because we play 5 nights in Cologne at an arena of about 12 to 15,000, and every night was sold out. And when we played in Dublin, we played to a 45,000 seat stadium. So it was pretty amazing.
You know, it's funny. You talk about all these different stadiums, and certainly Ramshead is not a stadium venue. This is one of the more intimate rooms around, and it's a great venue to see anybody.
Yeah.
And you've played, you know, pretty much any kind of stadium show with Genesis. What's your favorite? What's your favorite place to play? What's your most memorable show?
Well, is there probably one? The most memorable show was in 2007. We were doing our kind of reunion tour with Genesis, and we hadn't been together for 14 years at that point. We played a concert in Rome, but it was a free concert. But nobody knew how many people. The manager said, "Well, maybe there'll be 50,000, maybe it's 100, we don't know." 500,000 people came. It was an outdoor thing called Circus Maximus. It's just this big, big area that goes on forever. And you just saw a sea of people out there. And there's actually a DVD of that show. It's called When in Rome. And it's the actual show that was a 21-camera shoot. And it was unbelievable. It was probably the most memorable show that I've played. But, I mean, at the same time, I remember doing some shows with Genesis where we would... back in the 80s, we'd actually play small theaters around England. We would just go and play to a 1,200-seat theater, even though we were used to playing big arenas. They just wanted to do that for the fans, and because a lot of people couldn't come to the arena shows because they were sold out. So we just went around England and just played these small venues. And in fact, I played the Rams Head with Mike and the Mechanics. They were there in March of 2015, and Mike Rutherford asked me if I'd go on tour with him and be his opening act. So I've actually done this as a solo act where I just use my MacBook Pro, and I had just basically a drum track, bass track, and keyboards, and then I played along with that. And my first show that I played on that tour was at the Rams Head.
Oh, how cool! I did not know. I remember when Mike Rutherford had come back, but it was I don't remember. I didn't attend the show, but that's really neat. Well, you're going from a 500,000 person audience at Circus Maximus, which for those that are listening that aren't aware, that's like four or six football fields just all sort of stretched out. It's gigantic. You're going into a duo now. You don't have, you know, a full band. And I understand your keyboardist is a Russian savant, as you are with the guitar.
Yeah, he's a guy that I met back in 1990. He actually came to the United States in 1990. He actually came across the Atlantic Ocean on a freighter ship and came into Milwaukee, Wisconsin, which I live. And that's how I got to know him, because somebody introduced me to him. And at that time, he didn't even speak English. And he was a classical pianist, and he has like the equivalent to a PhD. He went to the St. Petersburg Conservatory, which is like going to Juilliard.
Wow.
And has PhD in classical piano and in orchestration. So he's an incredible musician, and we've been playing together ever since. And he's in my band. He's in my duo. The only thing he's not involved with me is when I play a solo concert. But that's what we're going to do at the Rams Head. It'll be the two of us, and I'm going to have my MacBook Pro, which I played the bass guitar parts on, and I programmed the drums on there. And that's what we're going to do, and it seems to really work well.
What do we expect? Do we expect some songs from Genesis, some Daryl Steurmer songs? And where do we...
Well, what I do is I do a combination of things. I'll play a Genesis song, then I'll play an original song, and then I'll even cover someone else, because I have a new CD that's come out. I shouldn't say it's come out yet, because actually I'm going to just be selling this at shows right now until I actually put it out, on the internet or wherever. It's called Breaking Cover, and I do cover songs. I do a Jeff Beck song. I do a Peter Gabriel song. I do a Genesis song. I just do songs by different people.
Interesting.
And so I'm going to add that into the show too, where I do a song by Peter Gabriel, instrumentally, by the way. I do not sing. And I'll do a Genesis song.
Yeah, you and me both.
yeah. I don't want to lose people with me singing. So I actually going to do a cover. It's basically cover some music, cover some Genesis music, and cover my own original songs.
Fabulous. And just out of curiosity, I mean, you said both you and your brother were guitarists. Was music in your family growing up?
You know,
I mean, were your
parents? A little bit. Yeah, my father played drums, but he didn't really play drums professionally. He played it in the Navy.
Okay.
So that's the only place really. But he got me interested in it. And then my brother got me, and I wanted to be a drummer first. And then when I was going to try out for the grade school band, they kind of said, oh, we need trumpet players. Try this. I became a trumpet player for quite a while. I played trumpet through grade school all the way through high school. But in the middle there, at 11 years old, I kind of changed over to guitar, even though I was still playing trumpet in band. And so it just kind of started from there. So
it's a good thing the drumming thing never worked out, man. That whole Genesis thing would have been totally screwed
yeah,
up.
I would have never worked with Phil Collins, would I? Well, maybe I'd be the other drummer, you know, like Chester Thompson was with us for many years. So
right.
And right now, I don't know if you know this, when we're on tour now with Phil Collins, his son is playing drums. It's an incredible thing. The kid is 16 years old. And I talk about a chip off the old block. This kid is so good on the guitar. And he's a great kid, too. So he's a super talent. And he's he's an amazing player and an amazing person.
That's got to be pretty special to be able to play with your old man on tour and get the respect and everything else for the kind of crowds that you guys draw. Daryl Steurmer, I am looking forward to seeing the Daryl Steurmer duo at the Ram's Head on the 25th of October, coming in from Milwaukee for one night only. And then you will be off to the UK next month for a little bit of an extended tour with Phil Collins. Daryl Steurmer is the lead guitarist for Genesis. Thankfully, he never did too well on the drums because he never would have had that gig. But we'll be here with, how do you pronounce your pianist? Is it Kostya?
Yeah, Kostya.
Kostya. Right. Both gentlemen are virtuosos in their art with the guitar as well as the piano. All right. Well, I want to encourage everybody. There are a few tickets still left to see Daryl Steurmer at the Ram's Head on the 25th. You can get them at ramsheadonstage.com. I'm looking forward to seeing you in such an intimate venue there as well. They said that you sometimes do Q&A sessions with the audience. Is that an impromptu thing?
Oh, right.
Or is that a thing that's scheduled?
I was wondering about that myself too, because I always in an intimate setting like that, you can do that. So I might actually put out if they don't mind, I want to do that. I want to do a little bit of a question and answer part in the middle.
Oh, I'm sure they would love that. That would be awesome. I think it would be fascinating for everybody that's there just to get some, get the chance to talk to you and see what's in your mind. Daryl Steurmer, thank you very much for your time this afternoon. Safe travels east to the Ram's Head on stage again for the second time. And best of luck to you and your tour with Phil Collins coming up in November and December.
That's right. Well, thank you very much, John.
All right. Thank you very much.